Okay, greetings y'all, Renegade Biker 24 again, and what you're looking at is something I got from Amazon, which took a while, and the problem was they had to go through customs, which is kind of amazing, and it took over a week to get, but this is the flag poles that I got with the eagles on them, and as you can tell here, it's the American flag and the POWMIA flag, and then over here is the Navy flag. All of these I will put a link to in the description to where you all can find it on Amazon, but this one right here, the POWMIA flag, that is very important to me. I am a big supporter of the POWMIA flag and in the cause of that, which says you are not forgotten. Now, I will keep this flag up until every American is home from any and all conflicts or countries that the U.S. has been involved in, and especially the one in Afghanistan, where our current president, that doesn't know anything about history, nor probably even cares, or even cares about what happened at the Fall of Saigon. Yeah, well, apparently he doesn't give a damn. So, I would suggest that you all look into getting this flag. It's a nice flag. It's double stitched, and it's fade proof. Like I said, it is a flag that I will fly every day. And I've also got some POWMIA stickers on the way. But I wanted you all to see this because, like I said, I am a big POWMIA supporter, and there has been times that I have been very active in it. And one of them was when I had adopted a missing serviceman from Vietnam, and his wife had actually contacted me. He was lost in 1966. Keep in mind, I was born in 1967. And, well, what happened is that the plane had been shot down and there was no survivors. Well, problem is that there was a helmet floating in the ocean near Bac Long Vi Island, which is off the coast of North Vietnam. And what happened was that there was that helmet floating in the ocean and they didn't know what it was, as well as it was cut. So I guess, you know, that remains to be seen on what happened there, but the wife of the missing serviceman had contacted me through Operation Just Cause, and she didn't know what to do, so I contacted the Navy Casualty Department, and they told me that she would need to fill out a next of kin and to give them her authorization to search Bac Long Vi Island. Well, what happened after that was I contacted her and she told me that I was her angel. And I told her, well, I'm no angel, I just care. Now, if more people would get involved in the POWMIA issue, maybe, just maybe, we can get all of our missing servicemen home, because I don't like seeing this happen. But I wanted you all to see this, because it is a very, very good thing to get involved with. And the whole situation with Afghanistan really, really kind of ticked me off with this current administration and how they don't give a damn. And this right here is the Navy flag. I was in the Navy, and this flag represents my time in the Navy, as well as all those who have served before me and after me. But I want you all to see this. The Navy flag has the ship with the eagle and the anchor on it, against the dark blue in the United States Navy flag, or United States Navy banner below it. Anyway, I just wanted to discuss this with you all, because this right here is important. Now, I could have a thing like F Joe Biden and F all those who have voted for him, but I haven't done that, and I don't know if I will. Okay, well, before my camera cut off, I just wanted to say, before this whole incident with Afghanistan, I was still involved with the POWMIA issue, and I recommend that everybody that watches this video to please get involved in the POWMIA issue. It is an issue that a lot of politicians forget. They don't learn from history. They seem to keep repeating history, and instead of actually learning from it and doing something about it, they keep going with the same damn rhetoric, the same damn thing over and over and over again. They don't learn. And if the Fall of Saigon apparently didn't teach some people, it should have taught the morons that are in Washington, D.C. that shows what happens when there's such a pullout of a country. Odd that 20 years had been with Afghanistan, and yet it probably took, I think, about the same amount of years to get out of Saigon. I guess we don't learn from our history, do we? But anyway, just wanted to show you all this, because this is a big thing for me. I don't like talking a lot about politics, but it's mainly because it pisses me off. And this current administration really does piss me off. They have no accountability toward our servicemen and women. They don't have any accountability toward people that they left behind in Afghanistan. They have no accountability for closing the border. They have no accountability for any of that. But they have a whole lot of accountability to their base of the left, and how they like to be manipulated. But anyway, I just wanted to show you all this, and like I said, please look into supporting the POWMIA issue. It is something that needs to be addressed, and we need to learn from need to learn from our history instead of freaking repeating it over and over and over again. If you can, please look into the POWMI issue and please help support that, especially with the National Alliance for Families of Missing Servicemen. I will leave a link to it in the description box to where you all can see it. But please, support the POWMI issue. It is the issue that I believe needs to be addressed. And like I said, I will keep this flying until the day that all are home and all have been accounted for. But we will see what happens with the politicians over the years. But like I said before, as of now, I don't trust this government, and I don't trust Joe Biden, and I don't trust Kamala Harris. And if they don't do something, I am going to support the impeachment of both. But anyway, the other issue I have is of some of the generals that are involved. Although there are some that aren't a traitor, General Milley. There are people, still good people in the military, but please, like I said, please support the POWMI issue. It is something that is very near and dear to me, and will always be for the rest of my lifetime. Anyway, it's Renegade Biker 24, and I will talk to you all later.